Last subtopic for 5.2 is properties of determinants. Number one, the determinant of a matrix and its transpose are equal. And then number two, switching two rows or columns changes the sign of the determinant. Okay. And then number three, if two rows or columns are identical, the value of the determinant is zero. Okay, for example, okay, you can see here, row 1 and row 2 are identical. So, the determinant is equal to 0. Okay, a common factor of any row or column is a factor of the determinant. Okay, and then number 5, if every element in a row or column is equal to 0, okay, for example this one, okay, the value of the determinant is equal to 0. And number 6, if matrix A and matrix B are two square matrices, then determinant of A times B equal to determinant of A times determinant of B. Let's try exercise 6. Use the properties of determinant to evaluate the determinant for each matrices and justify your answer. Alright, without using any calculation, find the determinant of matrix A by using the properties of determinant. Alright, A. Given that matrix A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 5, 1, 2, 3. Alright, so the determinant of A will be equal to 0 because row 1, okay, and row 3 are identical. So, determinant of matrix A equal to 0. B, given that matrix A equal to 4, 4, 1, 5, 5, 0, 6, 6, 3. Okay, this one also the determinant will be equal to 0 because the column 1 and column 2 are identical. Okay, and then C, given that matrix A equal to 3, 2, 1, 0, 0, 0, 8, 7, 9. Okay, obviously this one, the determinant also equal to 0 because every element in row 2 is equal to 0. Okay, and D, given that matrix A equal to 0, 1, 8, 0, 3, 7, 0, 2, 6. This one also determinant equal to 0 because every element in column 1 equal to 0. Exercise 7, find the determinant of matrix A 3, 4, 2, 1, 0, 3, 2, 5, 7. Hence, evaluate determinant of 6, 8, 4, 1, 0, 3, 2, 5, 7. Okay, first step, we need to find the determinant of A. Okay, so now, choose any row or any column to find the determinant. Okay, so I will choose row number 2 because got 0 here. So, easy for me to calculate the determinant. Okay, let's start. Use the plus minus pattern sign, plus minus plus. So here minus plus minus plus minus plus. Okay, start with the first element of row 1, which is 1. 1 located at negative sign. So minus 1 multiply by its determinant, cancel row 2 and column 1, 4257 and then plus 0, all right? So when multiply by its determinant, it still you still get 0, and then 3. So 3 located at negative sign. So minus 3 multiply by its determinant, cancel row 2 and column 3. 3, 4, 2, 5. All right, and then simplify your answer. You will get negative 18 minus 3 times 7 equal to negative 39. So determinant of A is equal to negative 39. Okay, next, find the determinant of 6 at 4, 103, 257 without using any calculation. Okay, find its determinant by using the properties of determinant. Okay, so you can refer back to your notes. Okay, properties number 4, a common factor of any row or column is a factor of the determinant. Okay, refer to row number 1. Actually, you can factor out row number 1 with factor 2 equal to, okay, so 2 times 3 equal to 6, 2 times 4 equal to 8, and 2 times 2 equal to 4, right? Row number 2 and row number 3 remain. Okay. So, the common factor or the scalar here is 2. Take out 2. Okay. 3, 4, 2. 1, 0, 3. 2, 5, 7. Alright. Okay. Notice that the elements inside the determinant is equal to the element of matrix A. So, the determinant of matrix A that we get previously is negative 39. Therefore, scalar 2 times negative 39. So, straight away, you will get the answer. The answer will be negative 78.